MedCram.com.
Well, welcome to another MedCram.com Board Vitals question. This question comes from the USMLE Step 1 and Comlex Level 1 question banks. An 11-year-old boy complains of sore muscles, muscle cramps, and severe fatigue following exercise. Your analysis shows myoglobinuria. Which of the following enzymes is this patient most likely deficient in? Alpha-1-6-glucosidase, glucose-6-phosphatase, hepatic glycogen phosphorylase, lysosomal alpha-1-4-glucosidase, or myophosphorylase? Now, we've talked about these glycogen storage diseases in the past, and I would recommend looking back on a couple of questions that we've done regarding this. And if, again, if you review those differences, specifically Pompe's, von Gierke's, McArdle's, these are the ones that get tested over and over again. The thing I want you to be aware of is the fact that the patient is 11 years old. So, you know, he lived out of infancy and toddlerness, and he's only having muscle cramps. So this is one of the more mild types of diseases. So you should know which that one is. And again, let's go over that and review that. So let's take a look here at the glycogen storage diseases. So I've got them listed. There's about 8 of them. Actually, there's 9 if you can count the 0. Each glycogen storage disease is a problem with an enzyme in the process of making the glycogen and specifically storing it. So there's only one that's actually for making glycogen, and all the other ones are storing it. So what happens is the glycogen accumulates in the liver, and it can accumulate in different compartments, and that causes different problems. Interestingly, type 0, which is very rare, is a problem with actually making it. And so what happens is that the liver is actually pretty small in these cases, and it's actually quite mild. But all of the other ones that you would be tested on is 1 through 8. And let's go through those. So there's von Gierke, which is a problem with glucose-6-phosphatase. And this is pretty severe. They usually have problems very early in life. There's liver enlargement because of the storage of the glycogen. And the glucose is very, very low, pretty severely low. So these people have problems very early on. That's one of the things that you'll see with von Gierke's disease. Pompe's disease, which I have here in red, is a problem with maltase, and it's an alpha-1-4, alpha-1-6 glucosidase. And the key to remember with this is it is number 2, and there are 2 types. There's a pediatric and there's an adult type. The pediatric is pretty severe, and they're usually dead by 2 from cardiomyopathy, and all organs are affected because of this. With the adult, however, there is less of a deficiency, and they actually do fine up until later in life, maybe 20s or 30s, and what they start to get is lower extremity weakness, which sounds familiar here, right? So there's less of an accumulation. And what you'll see is you'll see these lysosomes in the cells that are full of this stuff. So lysosomal accumulation is key for Pompe's disease, which is type 2. And remember, there are 2 types of the type 2. There's pediatric and adult. Cori is the debranching enzyme. It's a milder form of type 1, whereas Anderson is a branching enzyme, and it's very severe. So think of the branching as severe, and the debranching is not so severe. I don't know if it'll be helpful to memorize amylo-1,6-glucosidase for the debranching, or alpha-1-4, alpha-1-6 for the branching. But you may need to know these, although Cori and Anderson are probably not tested as often. One that is, however, is McArdle's disease, phosphorylase. You should know that they just get muscle cramps, not really weakness, just some muscle cramps. So we're seeing a big diversity here. With HERS, it's also phosphorylase, but it's a much milder form of type 1. And phosphofructokinase is very similar to type 5, which we've got up here. And then finally, phosphorylase kinase, again, it's like type 1. You do have an enlarged liver. You do have decreased glucose like you do in type 1, which we have here, but it's also a milder form. So the key here is understanding that McArdle's disease, which is a type 5, gives you this muscle glycogen phosphorylase that you see here. So this glycogen muscle phosphorylase, otherwise known as myophosphorylase, is going to basically prevent the glycogen from being phosphorylated so it can be metabolized anaerobically into glucose. And this is going to cause accumulation of glycogen, and that's going to cause muscle cramps. So the key with this question is understanding that, first of all, this kid is a little bit older, and there's muscle cramps. So obviously this is not something where people are dying in, you know, 2 or 3 years of age. This is a less severe type of disease, and it's very classic for McArdle's disease, which is myophosphorylase. Okay, so it can't be A, which is the alpha-1-6, right? Because we get cirrhosis by the age of 2 here. Pompe is the alpha-1-6 glucosidase, and there's a type 1, there's a pediatric, and there's an elderly. Not elderly, but the adult one leads to accumulation and affects the lower limbs. Typically, it's in terms of weakness, not just muscle cramps, but actual weakness. And the pediatric is dead by 2, so that can't be it. So in this situation, A is actually referring to the debranching enzyme of the 1,6 glucosidase. It's a milder form of type 1, which remember is von Gierke's. And von Gierke's gives you liver enlargement, things of that nature. So that's not what it is that's going on here. This is a debranching enzyme, and A is Corey's disease, and that's not what we're dealing with here. So B is glucose 6 phosphatase, which is von Gierke's disease, and it's a much more severe form. So you get liver enlargement, decreased glucose, problems with uric acid, hepatomegaly, lactic acid, things of that nature. That's certainly way more severe than what we're seeing here in the question. So that's not it. So C is HERS disease, or type 6, again, a phosphorylase. It's milder like type 1. Again, this is not what we're seeing here. We're not seeing liver enlargement in the question stem. We're seeing something like muscle cramping, pain, especially on exercise. So it's much, much more mild. And finally, the last one is Pompe's disease. Most of these are pediatric. They're dead by 2. This is the alpha-1-4, the lysosomal, where the things are just not broken down. And they get all sorts of problems with hepatomegaly. And again, it's almost always fatal in the pediatric population. Certainly not something we're dealing with here. Well, thank you very much for joining us.